Kathleen Kelly. Hello, this is a coincidence. Would you mind if I sat down?
Yes, I would, actually. I'm expecting someone. Thanks.
Pride and Prejudice.
Do you mind?
I bet you read that book every year. I bet you just love that Mr. Darcy, and your sentimental heart just beats wildly at the thought that he and, well, you know, whatever her name is, are truly, honestly going to end up together.
Can I get you something?
No, he's not staying.
Mochaccino, decaf, non-fat.
No, you are not staying.
I'll just stay here until your friend gets here. Gee, is he late?
The heroine of Pride and Prejudice is Elizabeth Bennet. She is one of the greatest and most complex characters ever written, not that you would know.
As a matter of fact, I've read it.
Oh, well, good for you.
I think you'd discover a lot of things if you really knew me.
If I really knew you, I know what I would find. Instead of a brain, a cash register. Instead of a heart, a bottom line.
What?
I just had a breakthrough.
What is it?
I have you to thank for it. For the first time in my life, when confronted with a horrible, insensitive person, I knew exactly what I wanted to say, and I said it.
Well, I think you have a gift for it. That was a perfect blend of poetry and meanness.
Meanness? Let me tell you something about meanness.
Don't misunderstand me. I'm just trying to pay you a compliment.
Oh, why are you touching that?
Is this a red rose? No, you know, it's a crimson rose. Something you read about in a book, no doubt.
It's funny to you, isn't it? Everything is a joke to you. Please leave. Please leave, I beg you. Thank you.
You know what that hanky reminds me of? First day I met you.
First day you lied to me.
I didn't lie to you.
You did too.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I did not.
You did too.
I did
you
not.
You did too.
I did you not.
Yeah, you did too. I thought all that Fox stuff was so charming. F-O-X.
Well, I didn't lie about it.
Joe. Just call me Joe.
Sure.
As if you were one of those stupid 22-year-old girls with no last name. Hi, I'm Kimberly. Hi, I'm Janice. Don't they know you're supposed to have a last name? It's like they're an entire generation of cocktail waitresses.
Look. I am not a 22-year-old cocktail waitress.
That is not what I meant.
And when I said the thing about the prize club and the cans of olive oil, well, that's not what I meant.
Oh, you poor, sad multimillionaire. I feel so sorry for you.
Take a wild guess that that's not him either. So who is he, I wonder? Certainly not, I gather, the world's greatest living expert on Julius and Ethel Rosenberg, but somebody else entirely different. Will you be mean to him too?
No, I will not. Because the man who is coming here tonight is completely unlike you. The man who is coming here tonight is kind and funny. He's got the most wonderful sense of humor.
But he's not here.
Well, if he's not here, he has a reason, because there is not a cruel or careless bone in his body. But I wouldn't expect you to understand anybody like that. You with your theme park, multi-level, homogenize the world, mochaccino land. You've deluded yourself into thinking that you're some sort of benefactor bringing books to the masses. But no one will ever remember you, Joe Fox. And maybe no one will remember me either, but plenty of people remember my mother. And they think she was fine, and they think her store was something special. You are nothing but a suit.
That's my cue. Good night.